Assalamu alaikum, my dear student. I am Dr. Noreen Khan, lecturer of Biochemistry Department. Today I will discuss about carbohydrate metabolism. Carbohydrate metabolism. At first, we have to know what is the source of carbohydrate and what are the important dietary carbohydrate. Source of carbohydrate. There are rice, potato, wheat, etc. These are all are the sources of carbohydrate. Now come to the point, important dietary carbohydrate. Important dietary carbohydrate are starch, cellulose, lactose, sucrose. Among the starch, there are source of starches are rice, wheat, potato, etc. And cellulose. The cellulose will be found in case of the green leafy vegetables and fruits. Lactose will be found in the milk and milk products, and sucrose will be found in the cane sugar. Now come to the point, what are the intermediary metabolism for glucose? Intermediary metabolism are consists of two parts, anabolic and catabolic. Anabolic pathway of glucose metabolism or carbohydrate metabolism are gluconeogenesis. Synthesis of glucose from non-carbohydrate source is known as the gluconeogenesis. Another anabolic pathway is glycogenesis. Glycogenesis means synthesis of glycogen from glucose. And number three is lipogenesis. Lipogenesis means synthesis of fatty acid and synthesis of triacylglycerol or neutral fat or fat, because triacylglycerol is also known as the neutral fat and fat. So these are all the anabolic pathway of glucose metabolism: glycogenesis, gluconeogenesis and lipogenesis. 30 to 40% of dietary carbohydrate will be converted into fat always. Now come to the point, catabolic pathway of glucose metabolism. Catabolic pathway. Number one is glycolysis. It is also known as the Embeden-Meyerhof pathway. Glycolysis means oxidation of glucose to produce pyruvate in the aerobic condition and lactate in the anaerobic condition. Number two is HMP shunt. HMP shunt means hexose monophosphate shunt pathway. It is the alternative pathway of glucose oxidation. So oxidation of glucose to produce ribose sugar, carbon dioxide and NADP2H is known as the HMP shunt pathway. Number three is glycogenolysis. Glycogenolysis means it is the breakdown of glycogen into glucose in the liver and glucose 1-phosphate in the muscle. Here glucose in the liver, but glucose 1-phosphate synthesis in the muscle, because muscle has a lack of enzyme glucose 6-phosphatase. Due to deficiency of glucose 6-phosphatase enzyme in the muscle, glucose 1-phosphate is the last product from glycogen in the muscle. Now come to the point, next catabolic pathway is oxidation of pyruvate to acetyl-CoA. And another catabolic pathway is TCA cycle. In the TCA cycle, it is also known as the tricarboxylic acid cycle or Krebs cycle or citric acid cycle. It is the common metabolic pathway where acetyl-CoA will be oxidized and to produce reduced coenzyme and carbon dioxide and ATP or GTP. So, for glucose metabolism, brain, liver, adipose tissue are the main site for carbohydrate or glucose metabolism. Hormonal regulation of blood glucose concentration. Following meal, blood glucose concentration tends to increase in level, and after 1 hour it reaches into the peak level, and after 2 hours it will come back to normal level. So when there is an increased level of glucose in the blood, it is known as the hyperglycemia condition. Hyperglycemia condition will stimulate the insulin release from the beta cell of the pancreas and inhibit the glucagon release from the alpha cell of pancreas. This insulin will decrease blood glucose concentration and return it into the normal range by following mechanisms. Number one mechanism is uptake of glucose from blood, followed by glycogenesis. Glycogenesis means from glucose there will be production of glycogen, and this glycogen will be stored in the liver. So our glucose, which is extra in our blood, it will store as the glycogen in the liver. Number two mechanism is uptake of glucose from blood followed by lipogenesis, synthesis of fat, and this fat will be stored in the adipose tissue. Number three is uptake of glucose from blood and then converted it into cell by glycolysis, and then glucose will utilized in the cell. It produce pyruvate in the aerobic condition and lactate in the anaerobic condition, and oxidation of pyruvate into acetyl-CoA. Four is inhibition of the gluconeogenesis by inhibiting the key enzyme of gluconeogenesis and inhibition of glycogenolysis. So these all mechanism is responsible responsible for decreasing blood glucose concentration and back it into the normal range. And this all mechanism is done by the insulin hormone, which releases from the beta cell of pancreas. Now come to the point when there is a fasting condition or starvation condition, there will be stimulation of glucagon hormone, and this glucagon hormone will release from the alpha cell of the pancreas. So in case of hypoglycemia, when there is a blood glucose concentration decrease in the blood, then glucagon, growth hormone, catecholamine and glucocorticoid hormones, these all hormones will come out and they will increase blood glucose concentration and move it into the normal range. Glucagon will stimulate hepatic glycogenolysis and gluconeogenesis. On the other hand, it will inhibit glycogenesis. By this mechanism, glucagon will increase blood glucose concentration and back it into the normal range. On the other hand, catecholamine will increase blood glucose concentration from hypoglycemia condition by stimulating hepatic glycogenolysis. And glucocorticoid or cortisol is the hormone which stimulate proteolysis and lipolysis and make available amino acid and glycerol, which act as a substrate for gluconeogenesis. And by this way, this will stimulate gluconeogenesis and increase blood glucose concentration, make it into the normal range. On the other hand, growth hormone, which will decrease peripheral uptake of glucose, by this mechanism, growth hormone will make blood glucose concentration within normal. Now come to the point, glucostatic function of liver. Glucostat means when the blood glucose concentration is within the normal range in the blood, that is the glucostat. And glucostatic function of the liver is the intrinsic capacity of the liver, which will maintain the blood glucose concentration within the normal range in spite of hyperglycemia and hypoglycemia following meal or in the fasting and starvation condition respectively. Now come to the point, how glucostatic function of liver maintain. Glucostatic function of liver will maintain by the liver by stimulation of the glycogenesis and inhibition of the glycogenolysis and gluconeogenesis in case of hyperglycemia. And in case of hypoglycemia, liver will inhibit glycogenesis and stimulate glycogenolysis and gluconeogenesis. By this all mechanism, normal blood glucose concentration will be maintained by liver and some hormones. So these are all about the glucose homeostasis and carbohydrate metabolism in short. Thank you all for your patience of hearing, and Allah Hafiz.